just over the 10-metre line there. Azurin gets it back to Afoa, to Woolmore, the front row forward combination. And penalty one. And from this sort of range, Callum Sheedy nudged Bristol into the lead, and he's going to be 10 metres closer because there's been a bit of descent back to referee in Tempest. Kept flat and low once again. On target once again. And Callum Sheedy restores Bristol's three-point lead. Ball comes down on his near side, and the penalty directly in front of the posts is Bristol's. And Ian Tempest will want some words here with Will Collier. It's the easiest kick of the lot so far from Callum Sheedy. Ball goes forwards off the feet there, and Quinn's managed to win the penalty. Five kicks on goal so far in this encounter. All of them have gone over. Help from Harlequins. Tapuai looking to burst through the defensive line in the end. He's taken down by Callum Sheedy, but made some good ground there. Mark and Smith back inside. Advantage being played here. Thomas offside, and as a consequence, possibly a chance for Quinns to bring themselves back on level terms. Marcus Smith gets the pass out of the Tapuai once again. They will hope to come back for that advantage.
Offside.
So offside given against the Bristol Bears. Marcus Smith makes it three from three. His competition with Callum Sheedy continues. Baldwin. Quinns doing very well to keep this ball alive at the moment. Lewis bundles his way up towards the edge of the 22 again. Robshaw was looking for the contact there, looking to keep the ball alive. Penalty coming the way of Harlequins, and so Siali Piatau is penalised. That ball is lost forward, but they will come back for the penalty. Just grazes the far side of that post. Back again, Marcus Smith kept short, and Dombrandt charges through the gap. Brilliant run from Dombrandt, and then tries to wedge the chip over for Evertoy. Morahan is back and covers and clears, but the line-out will be inside the 22 for Harlequins. He's straight into his man, Lewis. And Quinns charge forwards, the advantage being played here. So Quinns have that advantage. Little chip through the gap. Marchant can fall on it to score. Ian Tempest wants to check this, but Joe Marchant charged through. It is still a perfect afternoon from the kicking tee for Marcus Smith. They've just gone across the field of play. Callum Sheedy popped it out wide. Bit of a gap there for Ed Holmes to charge into. He's going to take more than one to stop him. Randall, who's given a new front foot impetus to Bristol since coming on to replace Uren. Moulton, good hands. Luatua, they're queuing up outside here. Just needs to be held up to. Piatau beats out wide. The try is scored. Bristol respond immediately. Brilliantly finished off. There's this one. We'll be back to within just 3 points. But instead, it just goes across the front of the post. Randall, Sheedy, Moulton, Siali Piatau picked up by Luatua. Out the back of the hand to Morahan. He gets back inside and is dragged into touch by Evertoy, who celebrates knowing that it has gone red. One try apiece in the end. Joe Marchant, with just over 12 minutes remaining, was answered by Jake Heenan. But in the end, a perfect kicking display from Marcus Smith. The real difference between these two sides in very harsh conditions indeed in southwest London. The final score from the Stoop is Quinns 22, Bristol 17.